In this video, I'll show you a few more plugins that can help you streamline your work in KiCad 9. If you haven't watched my previous video on plugins, I recommend checking it out first. In that video, I covered some very useful plugins that you'll definitely find helpful. The first plugin we'll look at is Bulk Hide Silkscreen Designators. Let's say you want to hide the silkscreen designators like D1 or D2 from the silkscreen layer. Normally, the way to do this is by disabling the silkscreen layer. But the problem is that this will also hide the boundary markings of your components, which you don't want. To fix this, we use the Bulk Hide Silkscreen Designators plugin. To use the plugin, first, select the entire PCB layout. Now, click on the Bulk Hide Silkscreen Designators plugin. This will hide only the designators and not the outline of the components. If you want to show a designator again, simply select the component. Press E on your keyboard. In the pop-up window under Reference, enable the option Show, and then click OK, which will show the designators. The next plugin we'll look at is the Schematic Blocks plugin. This plugin is very useful because it allows you to save commonly used schematics, for example, a power supply circuit, and then reuse them in other projects. To use this plugin, first open the schematic editor. Select the entire schematic that you want to save and copy it. Now switch to the PCB editor. In the PCB editor, click on the Schematic Blocks plugin. Enter a name for your block. Click Save Block and then close the pop-up window. Here, I've created a new project. Let's import the block we just saved. Switch to the PCB editor. In the PCB editor, click on the Schematic Blocks plugin again. From the list, select the design block you want to import. Click Import Selected Block to Clipboard, and then close the pop-up window. Now switch back to the schematic editor and paste it to use the block. If you already assigned footprints when saving the block, those footprints will also be copied along with the schematic. The next plugin we'll look at is the PCB Coil Creator. This plugin allows you to create custom coils directly for your PCB circuit. Let's go through the steps. First, go to the footprint editor. Click on File and create a new library. Select the option Global and click OK. Now go to the main installation folder of KiCad. Inside it, open the Share folder. Then go into the KiCad folder and open the Footprints folder. Enter a file name for your library. Make sure the name does not have any spaces. Click on Save. If you've done it correctly, you'll see this new folder listed under Libraries. Next, open the PCB Editor. Click on the PCB Coil Generator plugin. In the Coil Generator pop-up window, select the layer number based on your requirement. Set the turns per layer. Adjust the outer diameter to set the coil size. Change the turn direction to clockwise or counterclockwise. Leave the rest of the settings at their defaults. Once done, click on Save as Project Footprint. Close the PCB Footprint Editor. Now you'll notice a newly created folder called PCB Coils. Inside it, you'll find a KiCad mod file. Go to the PCB Coils folder location and copy this KiCad mod file. Then go back to the main KiCad installation folder. Open the Share folder, KiCad folder, and then open Footprints folder. Open the folder you created earlier in this video. Paste the KiCad mod file. Now, open the KiCad schematic editor. Here, I have a schematic for a simple metal detector. In this circuit, I want to link the coil we just created to J1. To do this, select J1 and press E on your keyboard. In the pop-up window, go to the value field of the footprint. Search for the coil footprint you just created. Now, select the coil and click OK. To see the result, open the PCB editor. Click on Update PCB from Schematic. Then click Update PCB. As you can see, the coil has been successfully generated and linked to the circuit. To view it in 3D, click on 3D View. To connect the coil to your components, simply follow the usual connection steps. And here it is, a 3D view of the component connected to the coil. The next plugin we'll look at is Parasitics. This plugin is used to analyze different parameters of a wire in your PCB design. To use the plugin, go to PCB Editor with a PCB design. Now, select a starting point from where you want to analyze. Next, hold down Control and select the end point of that wire. Once both points are selected, click on the Parasitics plugin to run the analysis. And here you can see the results generated by the plugin. The next plugin we'll look at is the SparkFun KiCad Panelizer. This plugin allows you to panelize PCB boards using the V-cut method. To use the plugin, open the PCB editor with your PCB design. Click on the SparkFun KiCad Panelizer plugin. Now in the pop-up window, first select the units that you need under dimensions. Next, go to the Panel Size tab and set your panel size. For example, my PCB board is around 54mm by 25mm. If I want a 3x3 panel, I'll enter about 200 for the X value and about 100 for the Y value. Under gaps, you can leave the settings at their defaults. If you want to include panel borders and fiducials, enable this option. Once everything is set, click on Panelize to create your panelized board. Here you can see the panelized board. And here is the 3D view of the panelized board. In the next video, I will share some more useful plugins that will help you. Thanks for watching. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.